up, guys? It's Lady Calysta. Today we're going to be talking about the Amazon App Store, a new special offer, as well as Guns of Glory. This is going to be the second video on Guns of Glory, so if you haven't seen the first, go ahead and check it out. Now, as a quick reminder, this video is sponsored by the Amazon App Store. Now, there is a special offer that is different from the one in the first video that I want to make sure you guys are aware of. So there is a special offer from Fun Plus. They are the creators of Guns and Glory. Starting on May 4th, when you purchase the $49.99 Amazon May 4th special bundle on Guns and Glory through the Amazon App Store, iOS, or Google Play Store, you will get a Lego Star Wars Millennium Falcon Microfighter building kit completely free. Limited supplies are available, and this offer is exclusively available in the US. There are similar offers in participating regions, so if you're not in the US, be sure to check it out and see if there's anything that applies. I'll talk about this offer a couple of times in the video, so you guys don't have to keep rewinding it to figure out exactly kind of what the name is and what you have to do, but it is pretty easy to get. Now, what I want to focus on in this video is basically showing you the external view. So what we did in the first video is we talked about Guns of Glory as it relates to your own territory and your own castle. But this is a multiplayer game. It occurs in a kingdom, right, in a world. And what I'm showing you there is kind of like the world view. And you can see that we can do a couple of things. We can attack non-playable characters. A lot of those non-playable characters you can attack in a rally, and I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. That's the Red Guard. You also have the opportunity to hunt, and they make it really easy for you where you can do a quick search and it will show you kind of the next relevant level set of monsters that you can attack. And now it's really important to attack those monsters because of the drops that they give you. So they're going to be able to provide to you materials that you're going to need to be able to craft equipment for your leader. And you can see there, and I mentioned this briefly in the very beginning, I'm going to go ahead and attack a monster, and you can see that along with my troops, my airship is kind of, you know, along for the ride, which is pretty cool. You can see there, that's what it looks like when you're kind of fighting the monster, and you can see we defeated our Rat King at a level 6. Now, these guys do, again, as I mentioned before, they do give you kind of material that you can use to then, you can see there an animal pellet. Those are the things that we can use to then go ahead and craft our gear for our main leader, right? So you have your creation gear that we talked about in the first video. Here we're talking about the gear that you can create for your leader itself. And you can see here, this is what the guild invitations look like. So you're able to, and I'm just showing you guys quickly here, I'm in Kingdom 401. You can see these are kind of like the alliances that are coming up. Wanted to show you guys what they look like. You can have, you can put in applications for some of them, right, where you're going to wait to see if you get approved, or you can also just get invited to them. And what I wanted to show you guys is also wanted to show you guys the way that alliances work in the game. They are super, super important in this game, much more so than in a lot of other games. Also wanted to show you quickly the inventory. So you're able to access your bag, and this is some of the stuff that you have in there. Again, this all is free to play, and you're able to progress really nicely without having to spend a whole lot at all. It really is up to you. And they do provide a lot of opportunities to do events, which I just showed you guys there. You can see that's a creation, catacombs, quest. They have event centers, right? So a variety of different events. And you can see there, you can only join once your castle reaches level 17. So I mentioned this in the first video, make sure that you're focusing on that castle grind, right? So in the very, very beginning, once you hit a certain level castle, I think it's 6 or 7, it does drop your shield, and it can feel really scary, especially if you're not used to these types of games. You know, fear not, you'll be okay. You can go ahead, you will survive. They also do have a quest line, which I love because it helps make sure that you're progressing the right way, and it helps you also remind yourself like what you should be working on. For example, my lookout tower is a dismal level considering my castle level because I just wasn't focusing on it and didn't know it was there. But your quest line is going to help you kind of make sure that you're providing, you know, the right amount of love to all the different buildings that you have. Now, what I'm showing you guys here are my hospitals, which are super important. And if you guys have watched any of my videos in the past, you know that I'm a big fan of making sure that you have a lot of hospitals. The reason why is it is a lot better to have wounded troops than have dead troops. And as somebody that likes to attack a lot, I feel great when I see dead troops. I feel meh when I see wounded, right? So if you're defending, especially early game, you want to make sure you have a lot of hospitals so that when you're attacked, it's not like they completely wiped out all your troops, right? It also helps you improve your healing speed in this game. And then another thing that I want to make sure you guys are thinking about are your military tents. Your military tents are gonna help you make sure that you are training as many troops as possible and as quickly as possible. So you wanna make sure military tents and hospitals, you're really doubling down on that. So that you're able to kind of take advantage. Now, I did mention I would talk about guilds and alliances. This is it. That is the home screen of your alliance, and you can see there is a whole lot of things you can do. You have an alliance territory where you can have a fortress, a tower, and each of those buildings are going to provide different buffs, assuming you're within your alliance territory. When you first join the alliance, you can see I am in ANZ. It does give you a port, so you can go ahead and port and it will send you automatically to your alliance's territory. Super important to do that because that is the only way that you can get some of your buffs. And I'm showing you guys here the store, the item list. There's ways that you can donate to have research, and that research is going to help your overall alliance, right? So you want to make sure everybody is contributing. You want to make sure you're constantly clicking help. And you can also kind of send alliance mails to everyone. And here I'm clicking help. I think I go back and I make sure that I request help for the buildings that I put together. And the reason that those things are important, you guys, is because when you click help and people help you, it actually minimizes the amount of time it takes to get things done. So you want to make sure that you're doing that. Now, I'm going to mention the promotion again, just for those of you that weren't able to capture all the details. So there is a special promotion, totally different from the first video. A special promo from Fun Plus. They are the creators of Guns and Glory. Starting on May 4th, when you purchase the $49.99 US dollar Amazon May 4th special bundle on Guns and Glory through the Amazon App Store, iOS, or the Google Play Store, you will get a Lego Star Wars Millennium Falcon Micro Fighter Building Kit for free. Limited supplies are available. This offer is exclusively available in the US, but there are similar offers in participating regions. So make sure and go ahead and check that out. Now, what I'm showing you guys here is the Alliance territory. So it looks pretty cool, right? Interestingly enough, when you join the Alliance and it ports you to your territory, it doesn't give you the opportunity to kind of go where you want. And that may annoy some of you if you're trying to port together with someone else or a group of friends. I thought it was pretty cool because it helps with the quintessential issue that people have when there are Alliance territories, that you have a ton of gaps, right? There's all these holes and you're like, oh, it looks so messy. And if you leave a big old hole in the middle of your hive, any big castle can port there and basically burn your entire hive down. So it's kind of cool that they do that. What I'm showing you guys here is just an overview of kind of where I am now. And you can see that for the most part, I am focusing all my leader points on economy. I really want to make sure that I'm maxing out construction, maxing out research, very similar to what I'm doing from a research perspective, right? In my academy, I'm focusing on construction research, doing the same thing from a talent points perspective, because it's early game and you want to climb as quickly as you can. So that makes most sense to do. You can see that the vast majority of us are unshielded. So we want to make sure if you're unshielded that you're not making any more troops than your hospitals can hold. Let's not give away red so easily. The other thing that I wanted to show you guys, which I think is really cool, is rallies. So there's rallies in the game and you're able to rally with your alliance members. This is what the rally screen looks like. Those are two rallies that my alliance has going on right now. And those two rallies are two non-playable characters. They're special. There's an event going on and we're going to get special rewards if we're able to beat those particular NPCs. And you can see when you're kind of selecting the troops that are going to go kind of to battle, you can select your airship, right? So again, as we're thinking about airship, that's, you know, little me. and that's our rally leader. You can see everybody's kind of participating. This alliance is really great because everybody is super duper active. And I've been learning a lot, you know, playing with them, because a lot of them are experts at the game. And you can see there, those are the additional slots, right, where we can send troops. It really depends on the research of the war leader in terms of how many armies we can all send. And again, just giving you guys a holistic perspective of kind of what the kingdom map looks like. There's a lot going on, right? Because we can farm. You can see there There's a couple of farms. We can also fight non-playable characters. We can fight monsters. We can fight other characters. So there's a whole lot of fighting that you can do. And all of those things are in our best interest. So even as we talk about this rally, assuming that we win, we are able to get quite a few great materials that we absolutely need. And you can see here, we are marching towards the Red Guard camp. That's our rally basically hitting the camp. And you can see we are successful. So we did defeat the camp, which is great. And you can then see, it's funny, right? Because walking towards it, we're all kind of like one unit, but the walk away, you can absolutely see just how many people participated. So I wasn't kidding when I said this was a very active alliance. And we're all just walking back. You have the opportunity if you want to speed your troops, right? If you need them to come back very quickly or not, it's really up to you. This is the mail system. I wanted to show you guys kind of the battle report. I know a lot of you guys are interested in kind of what the battle reports look like. You can see that was just a complete bloodbath. We lost 100 troops. They lost like 83,000. If you go ahead and click battle details, you can see we had some really strong people in this rally. My little troops, you know, they did a little bit, not a whole lot. The worst part is they do call it out. So I know I didn't do a whole lot, but then they send the spoils of war where you can actually see exactly what you did, right? And it says causing 8% of the damage. And I'm like, oh my God. I won't say it 8% though, right? Like you just keep getting stronger as you keep grinding. But they do, which I think is really cool, depending on your strength, that's kind of the rewards that you get, which is awesome, right? Because sometimes our strongest guys put in a lot of work, go and boost, and they don't get necessarily any better rewards than anybody else. This kind of fixes it. So hope you guys kind of understood all the mechanics of the game. I think it's actually very straightforward to play. Lots going on, so it's a lot of fun. I will leave you guys with the offer. It is an awesome offer, so I want to make sure that all you guys are able to take advantage of it. If you're interested, the special offer from Fun Plus, the creator of Guns and Glory, starting on May 4th. That's the key date to remember, May 4th. When you purchase the $49.99 US dollar Amazon May 4th special bundle on Guns and Glory through the Amazon App Store, iOS, or the Google Play Store, you will get a Lego Star Wars Millennium Falcon Microfighter building kit completely free. Limited supplies are available. This offer is exclusively available in the US, and there are similar offers in participating regions. So be sure to check it out. Let me know if you have any questions down below. And as usual, thank you so much for watching.